website. Due to our having a more of, or creating more of an online presence, you see here we have our products, our CDs. I'd like for you, Lisa, to go to our cultural curriculum kits so we can show you some of our instruments that are packaged in a set. So the set of instruments combines different countries. We want everyone to value and to understand the benefits of the instruments. So I usually start off talking about the instruments, saying where they're from, how they're made, and showing how they work. But this time around, I started to think about going back to school and how everyone right now, because we are in quarantine, or rather we're not able to go out and do our interaction, we need to look at ways that children as well as ourselves can be able to exercise and interact. And so here we have our rattle and roll kit, which is a kit composed of the frog, a rain stick, of course our beautiful rain stick, and we have a couple of our nut rattles, and there is even, or I should say, there's a CD as well, and we provide a curriculum guide. The curriculum guide gives all of the information of where the instruments are from, how they're made, and how you can use it for cultural connection. So that could be with storytelling. In addition to that, we have our mini sounds of nature kit. So this is, of course, the one that I'm highlighting for today, and that is $41.95. With any purchase of a curriculum, cultural curriculum kit, you will receive a free gift from the Pop-Up Shop Show. That's only for this weekend. So I just want everybody to know that. Our prices include shipping, so that is inclusive of shipping, and it usually takes up to about 3 to 5 days. If you'd like it expedited, then go ahead, give me a call. Again, the website is www.bigbrosses.com. Okay, Lisa, I'm going to take the website down, and now I will show you some of our instruments, which I'd like to give you a tribute to. Africa. Because this is Black National Black Business Month. All right, so we have the kashishis. I think somebody's not muted, but the kashishis are made out of rattan. They have gourds, and they are great rattles for little ones. Of course, these are all handmade instruments, as you see. The baby kashishis generally run $5.95 or 2 for $10. The larger version is $10.95. Again, that includes shipping. We have our beautiful kalimba. Kalimbas come in different sizes. Our kalimba is handmade, made in Ghana, made out of gourd. If you can see the etchings here, it's all done by hand. So this is, of course, again, flattened nails. Everything is recycled material, again, handcrafted. So after the kashishi, again, that was called kalimba. Both of these are from Ghana. We have our djembe. Our djembe is a West African drum. On our website, we show our baby djembe. Our baby djembe is about 12 inches high. This one is a larger djembe, which is usually you're going to see that in our World Classroom kit. And the value of this djembe is $79. Djembes come in various sizes, anywhere from the baby djembe, again, on our website for $39.95, all the way up to as high as, oh gosh, we have the larger djembes for a couple hundred dollars. You may not see them immediately on our website, but eventually you'll see those on there. And we have our communication. A lot of our instruments are used for communication purposes. This is called the talking drum. This is a beautiful instrument, and this comes with a handle. This is, the value of this drum right now is about $99. Again, this is a professional instrument made in Mali. So we will end with our sounds of nature, our froggy, which is made in Thailand. So again, if you notice, I said our instruments are from all over the world. Our frog is probably one of the most popular instruments with children. This comes in variations of sizes from the little baby, the kolki, all the way up to the larger froggy. This price on this frog is $14.95, again, including shipping. Our rain stick, which you've seen, can you hear? And the very last one is our thunder tube. So if you noticed on our curriculum kits, we had our sounds of nature, and this is inclusive of the rain, the frog, and the thunder tube for $41.95. If you order this weekend up into Monday, we will give you a free gift, and you will not know about your free gift until you order. So www.bigbrazos.com. We have our phone number on the website. If you want to talk to me and find out more about the instruments, or you have any questions, please feel free to call me. I thank you for being here, and I want to wish everybody a happy day, happy Friday, and we'll see you later. Thank you.
All right. Thank you for that, Big Brazos. Thank you, everyone, and welcome to the Pop-Up Shop Show here. We are going to do a lot of things to celebrate Black Business Month. This is Black Business Month, and we are going to do a couple of things to celebrate Black Business Month. We appreciate, like I said, everyone being here and selling online. It's all new to a lot of people, so like get ready, because this is the new wave. We will have up next, we'll have up Fab Life. Fab Life has wonderful, wonderful home decor. So she is going to get ready and show us what she's working with there. I'm going to put up a little poll question. So with us celebrating Black Business Month, we have a couple of poll questions. So let me see if I can find one that we're going to do. Let's see which one I can do. I gotta find a good one. Can't find a good one. Let's see. I had a couple there. Let's see. Oh, my screen is touching them. Let's see. Okay, so this poll says, we can have you guys see which one that you think is best. Let's see, which one is best? Ha, 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 ha. We get another one there. We have so many of them. Let's see which one we're gonna do next. That's an easy one. Everybody knows that one. I want to do one that we have not done. We done that one. We done this one. Yeah. We've done a couple of them. Okay, here's a good one. So let's see about this one. Who can give us the answer to this one? Can you guys see this on your screen?
See what?
Can y'all see anything on your screen? You can't see anything? Okay, there we go.
No.
Okay,
there you go. Who was the first Black man to make his millions from the hotel industry? Bob Johnson.
If you think Bob Johnson, go ahead and highlight his name.
Okay.
If anybody think, nobody think Nat Turner? You don't think he was a hotel industry person?
Oh my goodness, is this a trick question?
Okay, let's see. So everyone, it's 45-45. Somebody gotta break the tie. Who thinks? Is it Bob Johnson or is it Robert Church? Uh-huh, we can't break the tie. Well, it is Robert Church. He was one of the first Black millionaires to make his money from the hotel industry. There we go. So 50% was Robert Church. So we are going to be giving out some amazing gifts. Most of our vendors have a lot of amazing gifts that will be coming up. So you will hear about the gifts during our break. And next we'll bring up, like I said, Fab Life. Fab Life, are we ready to take it away?
I think so. I'm trying to come on.
All right, there you go. Come on. JMAZING, you can take it on down.
Grace, you on?
Yes.
Hello?
Hello? We don't see you. Where you at? Where you at, Fab Life?
Yeah, I don't know. I'm trying to do start video and it's not coming on.
Okay, let's see what we're doing here. Yeah, you should be able to.
Yeah, I was just on. All I see is my logo. Start video.
Okay, let's see. Try again.
Okay.
There you go. Hey, all right.
Hi, everybody. My name is Melanie Melendez. I'm the founder and creator of FAB, which stands for Fashion and Brown Beauty. We create home decor, pillowcase covers, and canvases mainly. Our home should be a reflection of us, and us melanated people are beautiful. I started in 2016 creating a line initially for my daughter to change her perception of herself. And then I moved into adult goods as well for the home. So I'm going to get started today by showing you guys a few pieces, and then I'll give out all my information is in the chat, Instagram, Etsy page, which is Fab Treasures. All the information is there. Everything that I'm showing you today is listed. And we also have a sale going on my Etsy shop. If you type in pop-up shop, you will receive 15% off of orders on $40 or more. Again, all of that information is listed in the chat if, you know, you didn't jot it down. So let's get started. The first item that I have, this is my Sassy Ballerina. This is a canvas. This goes for $30. It's a 12x9 canvas, as light as a feather. You can literally hang it on the wall with a thumbtack. You don't need a nail, a thumbtack, very lightweight. This is part of a collection called 22Q Collection, and it's based on ballerinas. Another one that I have is called Elevate, same thing. So all the pieces are made from vinyl that I hand cut and stitch on. So it's 3D, there's fabric on the background, and then the items are made out of faux vinyl and they're adhered to the fabric. Everything is clean finished in the back. Okay, very professional looking, packaged very nicely. And that runs for $35. Next, from the kids collection, this is our Tiara Puffs. This is a pillow cover case. The pillow does not come with it. It is the case only. It's a 12x12 zipper on the bottom. Okay, and it comes in 5 different skin tones. So this covers everyone across the board from light to dark. And then next, I also have a travel mug. This is a 16-ounce travel mug, good for hot or cold beverages, good for all year round. And this is $13 on the website. I think this is very economical, great little gift. And lastly, we have our Zodiac pillow covers. They're offered in all the different Zodiacs, 12 in total. This is faux leather that is stitched onto the pillow, so it's not coming off. It's machine washable, gentle, lay it flat, zipper opening on the bottom. And these also come in canvases as well. So before I depart, I'm going to show you what my Etsy page looks like so you guys know. And this is my Etsy page, Fashion and Brown Beauty. And you'll see I offer an array of items, but it's mainly canvases and pillow covers. Okay. And everything ranges from 13 to, I think I have one or two pieces for $50, which are the Egyptian hierarchy. But this is everything that I went over. So these are the Sassy Ballerina canvases, one puff or two puff. They start off at $30. If you want customization, $35 to add a name. Then I showed you this one, the Elevate. This is also a canvas, lightweight, hangs on the wall. It's 12x16 in size and goes for $35. And these are my Tierra Puff Pillows that come in a total of 5 different skin tones. This is the travel mug, just going over what I showed. This is $13, good for hot or cold beverages. And this is a Sagittarius pillow cover case. And they also come in canvases. I do the zodiac signs in either pillowcases or canvases. And that's pretty much it. All my info is in the chat room. If anyone is interested, come and visit my Etsy shop. And don't forget the pop-up shop coupon to save 15% off of any orders of $40 or more. Thank you.
Fab Life, can you leave up your website and go back to your Egyptian sets?
Sure. So this is the Etsy page and the Egyptian set. This is the hierarchy. It's Nefertiti and King Tut. And they are sold separately, not together. King Tut goes for $40, Nefertiti goes for $50. And the reason why she's $50, it's 3D. She's multiple layers. It's very intricate. And these also some other items that I have up on the site as well.
Great. That is good. Does anyone have any questions for her? Anybody are interested in seeing anything else before she takes down the website? You can go to the Libra canvases.
Go there as well. Okay, give me 1 minute. So these are the canvases. Libra. This is Libra.
What?
So as you can see, it's stitched onto the fabric.
Okay, great.
So these are my zodiac canvases.
Oh, those are really nice.
Thank you.
Really nice. So can you talk a little bit about your shipping? How long does it take shipping and handling?
Each item is different. Shipping, it can from, I would say, 3 to 5 days, depending on the item. I make everything myself. This is a one-woman shop. No one else is here to assist me. So I'm cutting the patterns, sewing, packaging. So I would say between 3 to 5 business days. But if when you go on the website, any item that you choose, it lets you know the processing time.
Okay, we had one question in the chat. It says, what color does the mug come in?
The mug is only in white. It only comes in white. That's the front of it. That's the back of it, one color only. But it's good for hot or cold beverages, and it's 16 ounces, dishwasher safe. Okay. Very economical.
Okay, well, thank you guys. If there's any other questions, we'll be taking some more questions. So if you guys can think of anything else, let us know. So thank you so much. You can go ahead and take your site down for us.
Thank you.
We will have some more. We will have some more great and amazing vendors come up and share their stuff. So I see some more of them out there. We'll have JMAZING play. Let them get themselves together. And then we'll start bringing them up. I guess we'll go with Great Gale next. So Great Gale, we'll have you up next. So we'll play some music, some tunes until right at 8 o'clock. So that's about 4 minutes. If you want to go get yourself something and come on back, we'll have him play until about 8 o'clock. 8 o'clock, that's Eastern Standard Time for those that are in the East Coast. So we'll have that.
Everybody leave.
8 o'clock. DJ JMAZING, go ahead and take it on down for us. Take it on down. We are getting ready to see an amazing person come up with his amazing gifts and talents. So Great Gale will be our next vendor that is up, and he is going to show us what he's working with. So let's see what you got. Come on out, Great Gale.
All right. Good night, guys. My name is Yuwarna Hughes. I'm the CEO of Great Gale LLC, a business dedicated to making change. And I'm also the author of Afrofuturism manga, Bold Saga. When I look at the media, when I look at the manga industry, I've noticed that they have Black characters, but they're generally not authentic. When you look at media representation, you generally see the whole escape from poverty narrative, you know, the gang narrative, all these other narratives. And even if it's Africa flies on the face, poverty, we need to see a change. So instead of waiting for someone else, I decided to make the change myself. So after 20 months, I created Bold Saga right there. Brave Onwards, Limit Destroyer. It is an Afrofuturism manga that follows Masego, who is a meek teen, unashamed to fulfill his dreams and fulfill a promise he made to a family member long ago. During the tests and trials that he encounters, it leads him to a rite of passage that shows him what it truly means to be bold. It's 44 pages of Black excellence. It is so great. It's on par with industry standard Shonen Jump. It is incredible. And in addition to that, I've noticed that even Akon said it best. You know, America has Superman, America has Batman, but where is Africa's superhero? Shaka Zulu should be a superhero. So I was like, okay, that's fine. So as the story begins, Shaka Zulu is the first hero that you encounter in the story. In addition to that, I remember that Jordan Peele had said that story is the best weapon for change. It's the greatest way that people can associate with characters, can align with characters, see themselves in the characters, and then grow from that. So I incorporated that into the story. It's a story filled with laughter, filled with comedy, filled with drama, but all ultimately filled with empowering our youths, our young kings and queens, with seeing characters that look like them that are heroes. Your sons, your daughters, your nephews, your nieces, kids in general, the next generation, as well as ourselves, deserve to see ourselves as heroes. Even Bob Marley said it. Emancipate yourself from mental slavery. None but ourselves can free our minds. One of the best ways to free your mind and level up is to read. And that's why even on the back of the book right there, that butterfly looking shape, that's Fawahodi. That is the Adinkra for emancipation, for freedom. And it is one of the symbols that is used all throughout the story, because the Adinkra symbols are connected to African culture, African legacy, and African greatness. So that is one of the aspects that I added to the story. And for ease of comfort, I've added the QR codes right there for each of the products. GG1 is the ebook for Bold Saga. It's amazing. And GG2 is the paperback. So if you want the physical copy, that's GG2. GG3 goes over the digital bundle, also called the Bold Bundle. And what it is, it will give you the ebook as well as the digital posters for Destiny's Gate, as well as the digital poster for This Is Lit. And the fourth bundle, the fourth one right over there, that one is the best one in my opinion. It's the Legacy Bundle. And what it has two shirts in it, one for adults, one for kids, and it has the Rise Up shirt in it. It also has 5 stickers, and it also comes with the paperback for Bold Saga, because I believe that truly we need to see change. Oh yes, the shirt says Rise Up, because that is a sentiment all throughout the story. That is a sentiment all throughout this series. It's all about elevation and showing kids that they too can be great. So if I have enough time, I can just share my screen. Let me see. Oh, hold on.
If 21 participants.
Okay, give me 1 second. All right. So that is the Bold Bundle right there. Just to show you just what some of the artwork, some of it looks like. These are some of the stickers as well that are inside of the story. And Afrofuturism, hand-drawn, everything was created by me. In addition to that, there is the digital bundle, like I had mentioned before. And there is a trailer as well. And that just shows just...
You can go ahead and let it play. You can let it play.
Okay. Just to show you the quality of the story. And that is Bold Saga, Brave Onwards, Limit Destroyer.
Oh, that was awesome.
Thank you.
That was really, really awesome. Does anybody have any questions for a Great Gail? Anything about the pricing? Anything about how the books are shipped? Any questions?
I have a question.
Okay.
Are you Wani?
Yes.
Marnie Hughes. Can I get to your Etsy store through your website?
Yes, if you go to boldsaga.com/greatgale. No, if you go to greatgale.com/boldsaga, you'll be able to, as you scroll down, you'll be able to see the Etsy page.
Got it. Mm-hmm. Thank you.
All right. Well, thank you again for that. And do you have anything that you would like to give away at this time? Are you doing any special offers because people are in a pop-up shop?
Oh yes, the discount that I'm giving away today is called Amandla 20. That's also a word for power. And what that is for the Legacy Bundle, it is 30% off. So instead of it being $100, it's only $70 until the end of today.
All right.
Can you spell spell that for us, please, Yuani?
No problem. It's A-M-A-N-D-L-A.
Amandala.
Yeah, Amandla.
Amandala. Mm-hmm. Got it.
Thank you. Amandla 20. A-M-A-N-D-L-A 20.
Got it.
We deeply appreciate that. Thank you again. So we are going to be having another amazing person come up next. That would be Aroma Stories. She will be sharing her items next. So get ready, everybody, because Aroma Stories has a lot in store for you. JMAZING, take it away. And hey, you sitting in a box with family, you can't see them. Cause they ain't saying you got informants in the guidance. Look at the price of showing big house and diamonds. What are the suit down? Checking the new one down. Meaning and checking the teeth. I used to forward down. My uncle was moving the deep. What if I rules are down? Me, I just wanted a bill. Then I could copy a bill. Told me the right way to pitch. Told me where they snitch. Thought he had figured it out. But I was there when he got sent. Babies put the bill, they don't never get to see him. Cause he rapped for a season, write letters trying to free him. Steals was breaking them down, versions and raps on the ground. Fathers were nowhere around, but yet he the man of the town. Dope man, dope man, dope man, dope man, don't tell, don't tell. Never hug his kids again, the prosecutors don't care. Rich off of dope, if you let them tell it. Get a scale and a phone, weigh it up and sell it. They got rich off of cush, if you let them tell it. There's two sides of the game, man. They gon' make it sound like the little money was me.
All
right, nope, nope, you sure don't hear us. Are we ready? Aroma Stories, are we ready? Are we ready? All right, come on in here. Come on in here and see some Aroma Stories. Give us a good story, Aroma Stories. Are we ready?
Yes, we're ready.
All right. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Aroma Stories has been around for a little while, very seasoned business, a very smell-good business. Mm. So just take a whiff, because here she comes. Go ahead, Aroma Stories.
Hello, everyone. Thank you all for being here. This is our second run, and I'm just really happy that it's beautiful. You guys are here. We got a DJ. I'm having a good time, so I know you guys are having a good time. So I want to start off with my first product. My website is aromastories.com. See how it's spelled? A-R-O-M-A-S-T-O-R-I-E-S. And even if you spell it with a Y, S, you'll still get to aromastories.com. Secondly, if you use the code POPUP, you'll get 30% off for a limited time. I don't know how long, but POPUP, and only y'all here know, okay? This is the product. This is one of my newest products. It's Away Spray. Away Spray came about because of ants. I'm not an ant fan. I'm not a mosquito fan, none of those things. And I was actually making a hand sanitizer alternative. And I took it with me to the park and we laid out our blanket. And I was like, you know, I'm just gonna spray my blanket. I'm just gonna spray it all up. I sprayed my shoes, no ants. They were like, oh, we just don't wanna be here, you know? And I appreciate that. I sprayed my body, I sprayed everything. I spray my linen before I go to bed. I change my linen once a week, in a good week. The latest I keep my linen is 2 weeks. So, you know, sometimes you gotta freshen up your linen. I'm sensitive. Like if I get in my linen and it's old and I'm not, or maybe I've, let's say I didn't shower that night and I get in my sheets, I want things to be comfy and smooth. I don't wanna be like feeling things, you know? I don't wanna feel the itchies. So Away Spray. I mean, it just freshens up your linen, keeps away the insects, keeps away the mosquitoes. Away Spray is made with witch hazel, mugwort. I know you guys have heard of mugwort. Mugwort is one of the original herbs used for beer making, but it also keeps away the insects and it also enhances your dreams. So that's really cool that that's in there. With that, as a linen spray, I sleep very well. vetiver is in there. Vetiver comes from India, but the best vetiver grows out of Haiti. It was taken there by the French and is one of their major imports, and it's just that much more smoky. If you smell the Indian vetiver versus the Haitian vetiver, there's only a slight difference. But all in all, you're gonna gravitate towards that Haitian vetiver. I mean, just period, for all kinds of reasons. But anyway, vetiver is considered, how can I say? It is so calming, it's considered an antipsychotic. I've never heard of an essential oil being considered antipsychotic. So all those things, you know, we live in a very interesting world. These are strange days. A lot of people are having problems sleeping, processing, coping, all of these problems beyond our control. With away spray, not only can you keep away the insects, but you can keep away those thoughts that are plaguing us all around the world right now. God bless us all. Also, what's in here is clove essential oil. Insects hate clove. I got a story. I have a longtime and loving customer of mine. Let me not give too much information, but he called me because he had, what is that insect that gets all in your clothes and gets all in your linen? He didn't care what essential oil he put on him. He didn't care how much it burned. He just wanted the insects to stop. I wish I could recall, I think it's scabies or something like that. It's the same reason that all the department stores for a period of time started putting those tags on the clothes saying, this has been returned. Okay, he had an infestation and he called Jasmine from Aroma Stories because I will get into those forums like, you know, I will go like 4, 5, 6, 7 pages back into the search engine. I will read forums for days looking for solutions. Clove. Turns out the scabies, human lice, does not like clove. All kinds of insects don't like clove. So that's in here too. So away spray. I believe I've used up my time. Ladies, where am I?
No, you're good. You're good. Keep it going.
Okay, so I'm going to move on to the next product.
Yep, you're good.
This is hand sanitizer. This is a luxury hand sanitizer. This has a bit of sandalwood, lemongrass, sage, cedar, clove. It has all kinds of essential oils in it. It has, it's also a witch hazel alcohol base. This is 75% ethyl alcohol. Ethyl alcohol is the kind of alcohol that they make perfume with. I know you guys have heard of all the alcohol fiascos right now. That is from methanol. Like people who make liquor in distilleries, the first alcohol that comes off is the methanol. It's the simplest form of alcohol, and they pour it off because it's toxic. So in this whole grab and run for hand sanitizer, people were sourcing their alcohol from wherever they could. And they were even getting, what do they call it? It'll be labeled as denatured alcohol. You could buy it like 50 gallons dirt cheap, even 5 gallons dirt cheap. And if you don't know the difference, if you don't read the white paper, if you're using a middleman who don't care about the white paper, that's why all these companies are messing up. And that's why you see the list even at Costco, you know, all of these recalls. So Aroma Stories hand sanitizer is ethyl alcohol, 75%, meeting and or exceeding the levels recommended by both the CDC and the WHO. If this weren't a hand sanitizer, it would be an eau de toilette. It smells lovely, and it has moisturizing capacity. So that's on the website. They're bundle deals, 1 ounce, the 8 ounce, which I love. I love to just carry it around with me. It's real convenient. I just take it with me. We go to the store, it's with us. You know, I spray the fellow's hands. You know, there's a little toggle lock here so that I can spray or not spray. See that? Kind of fancy, kind of a little fancy, you know. I try and give you what you pay for. So, ladies, how am I?
You done, you got about 3 more minutes.
Oh, well, okay, well, let's talk. Oh, I also want to say that this is the small one. Mm-hmm. Get this in the bundle deal, and this is what we're giving away. today. This is going to be raffled off. This is the 1 ounce. These are very popular. So another really awesome product on my site. Oh, let me go here first. This is a new product. It's not on the website yet because I've been busy, y'all, but it's coming. It'll probably come like tomorrow. And we'll do a mail blast of like everyone that you've seen today and tomorrow. We'll do a mail blast with their links and their products so that you will not forget them, okay? So this is hydrating spray. This is a product that was inspired by my trips to Ethiopia and China. Just before, well, from 2018 to 2019, I went to Nigeria, Ethiopia, I went to Axum. I was on the Silk Road in Axum and then went to China and ended up on the Silk Road again. So that was amazing. The China trip was like only $275 per person, government sponsored. I know you guys have seen those dirt cheap trips. They are real, let me say. If you don't buy anything else, buy the silk. So saying all that, this product has everything in it from Ethiopian coffee to green tea to mugwort. And it is a spin on the traditional rose water and vegetable glycerin moisturizer. I know you've seen in kind of like the home healthcare industry, they have really simple and traditional treatments such as the rose water glycerin moisturizer, such as pine tar soap. Well, this, while it's not a soap, I was just using that for reference, lives in that world. When you come out the shower, you can pat dry or not, but just spray yourself down. This is a moisturizer. It has geranium in it. Geranium is one of the most beautiful floral scents. It smells like French soap, but with pink grapefruit, I've added for skin tightening, and with vanilla, it sweetens it up. And I don't know if any of you are familiar with Luxury Butter by Aroma Stories, my pink luxury butter. It is beautiful. It smells like sherbet. This smells like sherbet. And insects don't like geraniol, which is in geranium. So you can still smell like sherbet. And okay, maybe the bees might come by because you're a flower. So I gotta put that out there. But mosquitoes won't. You know, bees just come by to bless you. You know, they just come by to say, oh, you remind me of something that brings me joy. So I just want to put that out there. And I think, ladies.
Yep, you are at your time. And we do thank you. Does anyone have any questions before we move on? We have some wonderful testimonies in regards to Aroma Story products. She also will customize some items. Sometimes she sometimes customizes some items. We haven't gotten to AVP products yet, but she had the time to customize our hair oil. So she customizes hair oils. She customizes different body butters that she also does. So those are some of her items that she actually will customize for you and make sure that they are working and scented, or customize a scent. So we have a scent for the APV hair oil that we use. So just wanted to let you know about those things. We are going to take a little time and then we will come up next with Miss Diane from J. Denise Jewelry. Miss Diane from J. Denise Jewelry, you are up next.
Now would you let me serve? Cause I can ride your way.
You need a man that's bold.
Yeah. Well, girl, I'm wide awake and I'm open. I usually keep it inside, but today I'm outspoken. I really need you, Rachel.
Thank you.
All right, thank you. Thank you, JMAZING, for your time. JMAZING. All right, we are going to go on with Miss Denise. Are you ready? Miss Denise, are you ready?
I am ready, but I don't see the video.
I don't see you, Miss Denise. I see.
Diane. Yeah.
Okay. I see you. Let's see if we can get you on the screen. Are you, let's see.
It says the host needs to.
There you go.
Here we go.
All right.
Hi. Hello.
Hi.
I am Diane of J. Denise Jewelry. I am an independent paparazzi jewelry and accessories consultant here to show you some beautiful $5 fashions. So let's go ahead and get started. Like I said, we are a $5 company, so everything that I'm going to show you right now is only $5. And for today, if you want to purchase anything, it is free shipping if you say Pop Up Shop Show. Okay? So I'm going to be showing you the items, and I'm going to show it to you with a number. And you just, if you like it, just need to post that number and make sure that I have your name, email, and home address, and I will get that back to you. All right, so we're going to go ahead and get started with this beautiful set of seed beads. Okay, so I'm not going to use my bus right now. So this is the seed beads. You see, and it's number 76, beautiful in yellow. Beautiful for the season right now. All of our necklaces come with a pair of earrings. All of our necklaces have an extender chain if you need to make them longer. A lot of times you can choke them up if that's what you'd like. So this one is number 76. Number 76, gorgeous layers of seed beads. Okay, along with number 76, I wanted to show a pair of seed bead earrings that you could, because this one comes with earrings, but you can also mix and mingle your earrings. This pair of seed bead earrings comes in red, yellow, black, orange, various colors that you can match up with a lot of things. Okay, so this particular pair of earrings will be number 82. Number 82, if you'd like to have those seed bead earrings. Okay, moving on. Here we have a silver necklace set, okay? Very gorgeous, a nice statement set with these swirly circles that are connected to one another, this gorgeous thick chain, and here are your earrings. Like I said, every necklace comes with a pair of earrings. How beautiful is this? This will be number 55. If you'd like number 55, comment 55, and she is yours. Everything's $5, and by the way, everything is lead and nickel free for those of you who have issues with costume jewelry. Okay, here's my next item in copper. Beautiful tassels hanging down from this smiley face shape here with that wonderful filigree in the center. And you have your tassel earrings to match, and there's that extender chain. $5 for this as well. Number 14 for the necklace. Number 14, mine, if you'd like to have her. And I brought out before a ring that would go nicely with this beautiful necklace. It is also in copper and has cute designs on the portion of the ring. Our rings are all stretchy bands, so they fit most fingers, up to like a size 10. So if you're worried about the fit, don't, because they generally fit everyone. So this ring would be number 40, okay? Number 40 for the ring that could match that necklace or either item on its own, if that's what you would love. We also carry various types of bracelets. This one is called a snap bracelet. Why? Because it snaps open and shut. This one has two snaps for your wrist size. This one is in a gorgeous snakeskin pattern. They come in various colors. This one is in that black, white, and gray marble type color, and it is number 24. number 24 mine, if you would like to have that snap bracelet. Here is a wooden necklace. I'm just gonna open it by mistake. Here we go. Michael Snap, what is that? Here is a wooden necklace. Also, here are the earrings that come with it. Okay, two layers of wooden beads. And then you see these larger beads here at the bottom. Very cute, very gorgeous, very versatile. You can wear that with just about anything. I could have wore this today with what I'm wearing. Okay, really nice. Could be matched up with this bracelet. Okay, this is number 64. You would like to have this gorgeous necklace. So none of our items are very heavy, but they are all very pretty. This is number 64, comment mine. Okay, and again, I love to match things up. Here's another pair of seed bead earrings. It has the black in it, also a little yellow and white that will go nicely with this necklace. So the earrings will be number 5. Number 5, if you would love these earrings. They're very nice, really nicely, nice hang time on these earrings. Really cute. Okay, and we have them in so many various colors. And speaking of colors, here's another wooden necklace. Very, very colorful. If you are a person who loves color, here you go. So here are your matching earrings on the fish hook, wooden circles, and varying sizes of wooden circles here, and the wooden beads in the center of them. This one has 3 layers connected with this cording here. Really, really cute. Okay, and this would be number 41. Imagine the number of things that you can match this with because of all the colors here. You have red, pink, green, yellow, purple. Okay.
Okay, Diane, you have about 1 minute left.
And 1 minute is all I need. Thank you very much. I'm going to show another seed bead necklace. Good for this fall season. These colors here, very tribal looking. Again, there are the earrings. Okay, if you like that. Comment number 38. Number 38 mine, and it's yours. It has a matching bracelet. So if you'd like the bracelet as well, you say 38 set, or just 38 for just the necklace. And it can also be matched up with a different pair of earrings. These are just a white pair of posts. If you would like those post earrings, comment number 96, mine, and they are yours. Thank you for allowing me to share my wares with you. I'm so happy to be here, and I can't wait to do this again next time.
All right. Well, thank you, thank you, thank you. Does anyone have any questions out there for Diane? Does anyone have any questions for Diane? Does anyone have any questions for Diane? All right. I see in the chat, people really like the fact that you have a lot of items that are put together. They like the bundles, the necklaces. They really like those. So people are really liking those. Diane, do you offer free shipping?
I'm offering free shipping to you guys today if you just comment PopUpShopShow, and you will get free shipping. Usually my shipping starts at $3.
Okay, so we'll have some free shipping, y'all. Free shipping is always good, so we will have some free shipping.
I'm seeing numbers here in the chat. Are these people requested, or will you just have the numbers?
Listing your items. We will listing your items.
Okay.
Yeah, so we will listing your items as things are going on. So.
Okay.
Thanks
for having
me. All right. Well, thank you for next up, we will have Officially Snap. Officially Snap will be our next person up. So we will have Officially Snap come up when he is ready. Just show your screen and we will have Officially Snap come up.
Just see the same.
Thank you, JMAZING. You can take it on down. JMAZING, you can take it on down. We have officially come, and he is ready to go. Let me unmute you. Did I meet? Okay, go ahead. There you go, officially snapped.
Hello, everyone. My name is Michael Snapp.
She sent his numbers.
And I have a few items I'd like to show you.
She sent the dude numbers.
Okay, let's see who we got to mute. Let's see who we got to mute here. All right, I think that is Sanford Livingston. We'll go ahead and mute you. There you go. All right, Snap, take it away.
All right, yeah, Michael Snap with officially Snap clothing line. We're an athletic brand, and we're selling like different events of clothes, such as sweat gears, boxing gloves, women's workout gears, and everything to that nature. Want to get into the first item, which is a pair of boxing gloves. You got the front and the back area, lace up, fully leather boxing gloves, cowhide leather 100%, with the logo on the front area of them. Number one for Official Snap Clothing Line boxing gloves. These run for $60. Okay. Then we have another one, which is a women's athletic gear. And the athletic gear consists of a sporting bra, a sports bra, women's athletic gear, front and the back area of it. And then we have the running pants to go along with it. Got the tights to go along with it. All right, they run from extra small to 2X as well. Good elastic band up inside of it. And also elastic band with it, and also a hidden pocket on the inside to put your key while you're running, or ID or anything to that nature, which is number two. And then we have another one, which is our shorts and shirt outfit. Shirt outfit, they run for small to 2X to 3X. This is right here. All right, and then we have the shorts that go along with it. Our short area, we have the logo on the front area and on the back. All right, and these right here are not screen printed for the most part. They're sublimation, meaning that the ink won't crack or anything like that, so they last the longevity of the outfit actually. Okay, and then we have a running outfits. These running outfits right here, I have these in multiple color areas, which is actually gray. We have a blue and gold one, a black and gold one as well, with the top to go along with it, with a hoodie, and the top itself with a hoodie aspects to go along with it. Okay, these right here run for $75. And we have multiple other things as well with those running outfits that we have. Like I said, we have gray, we have all black, we have a blue and gold one, a black and gold one, and then we're also getting one coming in, one that glows in the dark at the back while you're out running as well. Now, for every outfit that is actually purchased on here, I'll give a free bag, which is a sports duffel bag standpoint, drawstring bag as well. Okay, Officially Snap Clothing Line can be reached on Instagram at The Officially Snap and on Facebook, Officially Snap.
Okay, are we done? All right, well, thank you. I do have a question. What is it, for both of your items, what are they made from?
Okay, for the jumpsuits themselves, I have one that's 100% cotton. Then I have a couple other ones that's polyester and cotton as well. And then the shorts and everything is made out of polyester.
Okay, and do you offer free shipping, or is there a cost to your shipping?
There's a cost to shipping, depending on the pricing of what is ordered. The shipping range between $3 to $12.
Okay. And the bag that you're giving away today, do you have one that they can see?
Yes. The bag is actually right here. Woo! It's a drawstring bag, and the bag actually has, it's like, almost like a sweat suit where you have a pocket on the side as well.
All right, well, thank you guys. That's what we're giving away for being at the pop-up shop. So that is exclusive to the pop-up shop. So I love it. Thank you so much for sharing your product. And can you give a little backstory? I know you told a little bit. What exactly was the reason for you to start your business?
Okay, starting a Fisher Snap clothing line. My brother is actually, his name is Warren Snap. He's actually the founder of it. I'm the owner and everything. And he became a professional boxer, and he started boxing at a late age. And the standpoint of, we was trying to find a good way to get the name out there and motivational aspects to let everybody know your dreams will always come true as long as you keep working for them. Never give up on it. And we came up with that officially snap, because once he became a professional boxer, he officially snapped and trying to do and reach his goals.
Okay, thank you. And someone asked about the spandex. Which items have the spandex? Or do you have any spandex clothing? I guess that was the question.
Spandex for the women items, which is these right here. This is a woman's outfit, spandex to the top and to the bottom, along with the sports bra as well.
And can they be sold individually or together? Are they always sold together, or are they individual?
They can be sold individually. Together-wise, the outfit is $60. Separately, the outfit, the sports bra is $25, and the spandex is
$30. Okay. All right. Well, thank you. Thank you, Snap, once again. We are going to have we're going to take a break, and then when we come back, we will have some financial information that will be coming up. So we will have them talk about financial services and things that we can do financially as investors, so with small businesses. So we'll be able to have a little bit of information in regards to, we'll be able to have a little bit of information in regards to what we can do financially. So we're going to take about not too long. I just want to make sure that the speaker is ready. So we'll take about 5 minutes and have them be ready. I'ma push me a hard back.
I get your hair drawn like a slut for your chest. Like a vest for your Jimmy in the city of sex. We in that sunshine state for the bomb and sippy. The state where you never find a dance floor empty and pills free. On a mission for them freeze. Leave me, money making machines serving me. I've been in the game for 10 years making rap tunes. Ever since honeys was wearing Sassoon, now it's 95. And they rock me and watch me, diamonds shining. Looking like I robbed it with Rachi. It's all good, from Diego to the Bay. Your city is the bomb and your city making pay.
All right, so I think I get to choose the raffle for today, or rather one of our raffle items. So I am going to choose someone who has their window open, who I can see. So everybody, if you want to be one of the ones to get the raffle, let's see windows open. Okay. Well, I'm starting to see people, party people. Okay. I think it looks like we are choosing raffle person, Violet Whitaker. You are our first raffle prize winner. Thank you, Miss Violet. I'd like for you to put your, you can unmute yourself for a quick sec. You will be our first raffle prize winner. If you can, please put your email inside of the chat privately to me, to Rachel, Big Brazos, and we can send your, you can give us your address so we can send your raffle prize directly to you.
Okay, all right, thank you. This is very nice, I'm enjoying it.
What brought you here today, Miss Violet?
A pop-up invitation.
Oh,
from somebody right. I know and love.
Oh, that's so great. All right.
Yes.
Well, we love for you to be here. Thank you.
And okay, you're welcome.
Your prize.
Okay. Right. Thank you. My pleasure.
Okay. All right. We will be hearing next from Everett. Everett, ready? He will be the next person up to speak. So we are waiting for Mr. Everett. Everett, when you are ready, just open your window and we will look forward to hearing from you. Okay, so Everett is ready. Jay Amazing, we are going to hear from Mr. Everett and hear what he has to say. So there you go. Go ahead and tell us a little bit about yourself, Everett, and we're ready for you.
Okay, first of all, I want to say peace and greetings and strength and health to everyone out there. And it's just amazing to see all these Black businesses come together, because we are the paradigm shifters, and you know, we are revolutionizing how we're dealing with retail and consumers. But today I'm here to talk about getting into stocks. I'm not, just a disclaimer, I'm not a financial advisor or a financial planner. It's just information that I want to share with you guys that I think that will be helpful for you and with your financial journey. So the first thing I wanna say is, especially for all the businesses out there, now that you have a stream of income from your product, what do you wanna do now? Like how are you gonna flip your money, or how do you want to long-term invest your money? Well, if you decide to keep your money in a bank, you're only gonna get 0.001% of your total income. So you can't really make any moves that way. If you invest in stocks, you get a return of about, you know, 8 to 15%, which is a higher number, and you can accelerate your financial goals a little quicker that way. So that's the difference. So, and think about this too, when we talk about inflation actually rises 3% each year. So if you're saving your money in the bank and it's only getting 0.01% and inflation is 3%, for example, if you bought a candy bar last year, it was a dollar. Now it's $1.01 the following year. I'm sorry, $1.03, and the money that you're making in the bank is only giving you not even a penny. So you're behind the scale. So what's happening is, you know, wealth is not really built by just saving money. Wealth is built by, you know, real estate, investing, stocks, and things of that sort. So that's just a little backdrop of, you know, segueing to this conversation. So the question you got to ask yourself is, why invest in stocks? Why is this important for you? You know, just think of it as another form of stream of income for you. Just like your business is a stream of income for you. Now, back in the day, if you wanted to invest in stocks, you would go to Charles Schwab and you would have them actually, you give them a certain amount of money and then they would, you know, manage your account. So they're not really telling you what they're managing. They're just letting you know what the return is based on statements that they might send to you in the mail. And then you can see how your money is growing that way. But now with these different apps, which I'll talk about in a little bit, you can skip the middleman and actually get inside of the stock industry and get direct quotes and trading in real time. So that's what a lot of people are doing right now, is jumping into stocks. So, you know, there's two type of stock individuals. The first type of, I'm sorry, that's my dog. The first type of investor would be a day trader. This is a person who, you know, you can trade penny stocks. Penny stocks are anything that's under $10 or less. They call those penny stocks. They're not actually pennies. That's just a nickname. But they invest in penny stocks, or they invest in foreign exchange. They call it Forex for short, foreign exchange, or companies in China, Europe, you know, just, you know, all over the world. You can invest in that. You can invest in bigger companies like Amazon, Netflix, things of that sort. So they're trading these stocks all the time, every day. And it's high pace and it's very risky. So the average person is not day trading that way. But when I talk about investing in stocks, for example, you can pick a company that you actually integrate in your life. Like, for example, if you like to wear Nike, you know, maybe you might want to think about investing in Nike. Or if you're a gardener, you might want to do Home Depot. So the suggestion that I'm giving is that most people should invest in the company that they feel good about. And it's the long-term planning of investing in stocks. So for example, if I invested in Home Depot today and I bought a stock, you know, let's say I think Home Depot is about $200 now. And I bought one stock of that. And I continue to do it over the next couple of months. When the stock goes up, then my actual whole portfolio is going to go up. It might go down, but you got to think about it. 5 years from now, you're going to have way more money than you did before. So even if you don't have the number that you want to get, the number that you wanted to make in your mind, but at least you're in a better position than you were before. There's an old saying, it's good to grow a tree. It was good to grow a tree 5 years ago, or it's good to grow a tree today. So it doesn't matter, just grow the tree. So So I suggest for most people just to have long-term investing. Think about your 401k plan or your pension plan. Just think of it like that and just invest in it over, you know, a period of time, you know, 5 years, 7 years. And there's actually a tax law. It's called, it's a tax break. It's called long-term tax break, where if you hold on to a stock for more than a year, you get a really low tax percentage of that earned income. So at the end of 7 years, you can take that money, you can sell your stock, you can invest in something else, or whatever you want to do. But I would suggest that for most people. And I'll give the other side about stock, you know, selling stocks and things of that sort. You can make money and things of that sort, but you can't have any emotions in stock, because the stock market don't care that you've been saving that money for 10 years, or your grandmother that was working for the county, you know, she saved up $50,000, she was able to give you $10,000. You can lose your money that quickly, very quickly. So you can't be emotionally attached to money if you want to invest in stock. Because some people, they actually watch their stock every day. They start panicking when it goes down and things of that sort. That's not a good long-term investor. They say that 90% of people who invest in stocks fail. But anyway, I just wanted to give you a background on that. But what you want to do, if you want to get started in opening up a stock, you have different stocks like, different companies like Ally Investment, Robinhood, American Trade. All you do is call the representative and tell them that you want to, you know, open up an account with them. They're going to ask you information about your bank, is, you know, your routing number, things of that sort. So you can be able to transfer money into their account, and instantly you can be able to trade stocks right then and there. So it could be $50, $100. There's no limit of how much money you can invest. But I would suggest that everyone invest in stock. It's risky, but the returns are great as well. So there's also other ways you can kind of test the situation out. You can do trading with, it's kind of like fake money, you know, and see how you do before you really want to put yourself out there. But it's not complicated. You know, you want to just be with a company. You got to read the financials. You got to read up on the company. You got to do your homework before you actually invest in a stock. Don't just invest in it because it's hot or something you heard on the internet. So there comes a certain level of diligence and research that you have to do when you're investing in stock. That's the responsibility that comes with it. So, you know, keep your eye out on the stock market, see what's going on across the world. Start out small. It's very simple to invest in stocks. I suggest that you pass this information down to your, you know, your children or young people. Like, you know, all Black people, two things we should know about business, and we should know about the stock market. So the door is wide open for us right now. So is there any questions? I know I was all over the place.
Yeah, no, that's fine. Thank you so much for your time giving us a little stock information. Does anybody have a quick question? We have one more speaker to come up, and he's getting ready, so he'll be up shortly. Does anybody have any questions for Everett?
There was a question in the chat that said, how is this different from 401ks? From, let's see, Miss Violet had the question.
Ira.
Miss Violet, what was your question?
How is this different from an Ira, as she said?
From Ira, thank you.
How is it different from a 401k?
Yeah.
Okay, so a 401k is a part of your job, which is pre-tax most of the time, so they'll take out money in your salary. And they have a company that they work with, a trading company, like Charles Schwab or Merrill, like that. They will take your money and they will ask you different questions like, what is your risk factors, high, low, and things of that sort. And then they would pick stocks for you and things of that sort. They do that for you. So when you retire, you take this money, this fund in the stock market, and then you can do whatever you want. In the stock market, you're actually, it's nothing to do with your job. It's just directly taking stock with that company and letting it grow. So remember, when you're when you're buying stock, you're owners of that company. So I'm saying, if you are purchasing something all the time, be a part of that company and you'll grow with them. So you're already spending money. So.
Okay.
All right. Thank you.
You're welcome.
All right. Thank you guys. And again, we can never hurt by learning different financial angles and ways to invest our money. We are all small business owners. And we all have, some of us have dibbled and dabbled in corporate America as well. But we all know that, especially in this country, you have to have money to survive here. So the next person I have coming up, he has worked in major banking and he has worked in small banking. He is a CEO of a nonprofit, if I'm going to get that right, of a nonprofit called North Cal FDIC. And he is going to give, especially the small business owners, some information that I think if you guys have pieces of paper, pencil, you'll need to write down the information that he'll give you. He's going to talk about different aspects, especially directed to small business owners. Sanford Livingston, go ahead and take it away. I appreciate you coming on. And Everett, we also appreciate you stepping in and coming on too.
Excellent. Excellent.
All right.
Can you hear me, Liz?
We can. We can definitely hear you.
Okay. All right. And so the brother that just spoke, that was an excellent, excellent presentation. And just to let you know, there's a 401k for small businesses. It's the same apparatus, but it's a kind of a tax-free way of saving as a business owner. But at the same time, you're not an employee. So as the brother mentioned, the 401k plan is to save money in a mutual fund type of setting, whether it's aggressive or conservative with the company. But you do have the ability to have that type of apparatus for small businesses as well. Right now, I'm Sanford Livingston. I'm the CEO of NorCal FDC Financial Development Corp in Oakland, California. And I'm not sure of all the things that Lisa wants me to cover, but what we do in California is we're an agency of the state in particular. There's a bank called the Infrastructure Bank of California that we are we have a contract with, and our job is to entice banks to want to lend money, or what they call a CDFI, a community development financial institution, that makes loans to small businesses, and sometimes it's really tight because of the folks, you know, being eligible for loans for whatever reason, no collateral, low collateral, not in business long enough, those kinds of things. We do what we call loan guarantees. So for instance, if you approach, or if you're trying to get a loan for, say, $50,000, we can guarantee up to $40,000 of that loan. And that would make the bank feel more secure in making that particular loan. I have a website. It's www.nor-calfdc.org that explains a lot of that. Right now, in particular, folks are really trying to figure out, government folks and institutions, on how to get funds to small businesses, and in particular, Black small businesses, Brown small businesses. And one of the things that, I'm just going to give you some of the generic ways I think you can really look at getting that kind of help. And one of them is with SBDCs, Small Business Development Centers. Are many of you guys familiar with that? Lisa, can you see names or hand raising to see if anybody really understands Small Business Development Centers right now? Well, look those up. There are about 1,200 small business development centers around the country, and they are there to help small businesses with all kinds of technical assistance, understanding how to put your business plan together, understanding finances, understanding
Legal assistance as well.
Legal assistance as well. All those types of things. Are any businesses in particular online that are from California? If not, that's okay.
Yeah, we have a couple. We have a couple. We have Aroma Stories that's on from California. We have Big Brazos that's on from California. So yeah, we have a couple on. And Denise?
Well, what I'm going to
J. Denise Jewelry is on from California, so we have a couple of them.
Okay, and for those that you just mentioned, are any of those businesses have any introductions to the small business development centers in their region?
I don't think so.
I do. I have connections to the El Camino SBDC. So I've gone through their program. Well, I've done paperwork with them.
Okay, and the reason why I ask is because what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually send you my information for everyone to contact me, and I want to give everyone information about, because I actually have a particular partnership that I can get to most any of the businesses in California, even though I'm in Oakland, and get you the intake forms and those kinds of things. So you can get access to the types of information that I know you can, because if you use the tools that I'm looking at that we have, we can possibly, you know, help you position your company to start receiving some capital. Maybe there's some grants that are just now becoming eligible. Folks they got a proposal right now in Sacramento. For how to get grants, and particularly the brown skin folks. And because that's what I wrote an article about, you know, the issues with the stimulus packages and how, for whatever reason, it's a long story, that we don't get access to those funds. Matter of fact, when you have deals that are 20,000 and below, like you may only need to borrow 20,000, 30,000. That number is such a unique number that many of the banks and lenders don't make any money from making those loans available. So because they don't do it, everybody passes the hat. And by the time it gets down to our folks and to our businesses, the money's either evaporated or misused. And so I'm working on that right now, but I want everybody to look up the SBDCs in their area. And if you have any types of issues with getting to them, I don't give a damn what state is in, let me know, because it's a federal program. And it, you know, those dollars, no matter what city or state you're in, you can get access to. And because I'm working very closely with some folks in Washington about that, I will make sure that you get, you know, some proper service for that. You want to make sure that you have your business plan. You also want to think about your financials. When I say financials, I'm talking about your income statement and balance sheet. You want to, you know, if you have QuickBooks, use QuickBooks. If you need some help, you need to have somebody explain to you, you know, your positioning with your income statement and your balance sheet. Some people say, for instance, if you're doing a lot of contract work with government, right? Government could take up to 90 days to pay you. So what's happening with many of our companies, small business, black companies, is that we have contracts where the payment is on we call it riding the trade. If you're dealing with a large company, like a Kaiser or somebody, maybe you're providing them with some particular medical device or paper towels or mask, whatever, they take sometimes 60 days to pay. Well, how do you live? How do you pay your people? How do you do those things? There's something called gap financing that you could be eligible for. And so you want to be able to write words like the gap financing. You want to be able to write down words like, your debt service coverage. They want you to have a debt service coverage, you guys, of 1.25. So some people say 1.25 times or 125% times. And that's just saying they want you to have enough funds coming into the business to be able to make your payments on the loans that you're getting. So when you go into your business plan, you go into your request for financing, make sure that you can show your accounts receivables and your cash and your cash flow, but also know that what your accounts receivables schedule is. The reason why you need to know that, if you have one of those businesses that is heavy, you know, contract driven, where all your money is 60 and 90 days, any hiccups in people paying you causes problems with how you're going to finance your debt, and it causes issues which makes banks not want to respond to you. And so those are the types of things that I work through with businesses and talking with them. So one, you use the SBDC to help you, and this should be at no charge, by the way, you guys, and no charge. And then they prepare you for success in business, what things to look for, because you might be good at making widgets and have not a clue on what the hell it is when you talk about a financial statement, an income statement, and stuff like that. And people say, well, you know, I made $100,000 last year. So just give you an example, right? And then you look at the income statement, and 50% of that is in accounts receivable, which means they haven't gotten paid yet. So they may have cash flow of $50,000 out of $100,000, and then they can't pay the bills, they can't pay the people, they have issues, can't pay their taxes, and they're wondering what's going on, because they say, well, damn, I made all this money, what happened? But you have to be able to understand a lot of the other intricate business things, of which I would really like to figure out how to make sure our folks have that information. And I know I said a mouthful, but after I was listening to the brother before me talking about the stocks, I was going to tell y'all a little bit about that too. But I stay in my lane and give you the information that you need to make sure your businesses are successful.
So we have some businesses on from Florida. We have businesses on from Alabama. We have some businesses on. So we have businesses on pretty much all over. So do they just Google to get to the SBDCs, or what's the best?
Absolutely. This is called the Small Business Development Center. Mm-hmm. And there are 1,200 of them in the country. You do that and you figure out who they are. You send them an email, you give them a call. If you can't find out who it is, you give me your location, and I'll have somebody find somebody in your location to make sure that you're attended to the correct way.
Okay. And then would you say the best thing is to keep your books in order? If you're just learning about, you know that you're out there, you know you're selling your product, you know you're getting these sales in, and you're getting your money in. What's the best, would you say keep your receipts? What's the best way to write down everything? What's one of the best ways to kind of, when you're starting out, to make sure that you start out on the right foot to keep your stuff in order before you kind of go out there? Do you have any information on that?
Well, I say the best way to do those things is to use technology that we have. I mean, back in the day, you know, 20, 30 years ago, people kept their stuff in shoeboxes with receipts and all kinds of stuff. We don't need to do that today. We got QuickBooks, we got Intuit, we got a lot of ways to use technology, even as personal people. The banks now, when you're doing banking online, they break all your expenses into categories and help you to be more organized about how you spend money, how you use money. I think that if you think that way, then start off as though your company is large. So no matter what, go out and get QuickBooks and put all of your information, maybe not on a daily, on a weekly. Put all your expenses in. You keep your receipts as evidence of it, but you should keep the activity in a book. And you should keep your QuickBooks up, and you should keep them backed up. I would also, you know, no matter what, there's a lot of little kids running around with accounting backgrounds and those kinds of things. If you don't have enough, or if you're trying to save money, you're still coming up and you can't afford an accountant, you know, go grab an accountant student. Go, because you know, you're not going to have that much. It's not going to be that complicated. You're not going to have investments and, you know, all the long-term and short-term capital gains, like the brother was saying. Yeah, all that kind of stuff. You go ahead and grab somebody that can input. You get an input, get a quick a bookkeeper, much cheaper, and get those things. And so when it comes time to looking at expanding your business and having funds and organize yourself to go after more funds, no matter who it is, they're going to ask you for your financials. And you should have your financials together. You should have your taxes together. You should consider the right, and I don't know, I mean, I know them, but I'd rather you go out and investigate and get the right answers. But you ought to have the right entity, whether it's an LLC, whether it's an S Corp, whether whatever that is, you need to look at those options of how you're going to continue growing your business and what entity you should use, because they also ask you for that. The entity is important because it tells you how much of your own assets you'll have at risk. Because oftentimes when you're getting a loan, they ask you to be a personal guarantor, which means if anything happens, they can come after you, your house, your car, all that kind of stuff. If your business is in a corporation or an LLC type where it's not a sole proprietorship and you're limiting your liability, those are the kinds of things you need to be thinking about.
Okay. Well, thank you, guys. Any questions? Anybody else have any questions or any suggestions or anything they want to find out? I have one more question, and then I guess we can close out tonight. Can you go a little bit about the difference between, you know, some of the grants that are out there and some loan products that are out there?
Well,
a little.
It's really tough, you guys. I'll just let you know, right now, there's a lot of money available for businesses purely because of the financial and the political climate that we're in. Everybody wants to help people of color right now. Some is a guilt factor, some is finally people are waking up and understanding that, you know, we proverbially have had a foot or a knee on our neck for years. And now they're saying, you know, I'd like to figure out how we got to come around. There's a couple of things. Like, we got to, first of all, in social injustice, it's become a topic of the day. Climate control is a topic of the day. You know, I don't care what we're doing. If we don't figure out how to keep this planet running, you know, we're all going to go. And like I used to tell people, everybody wants to go to heaven, but don't nobody want to die. And I'm going to tell you right now, if we keep this up, you could look around. There's hurricanes, but there wasn't hurricanes. Right now in Oakland, it was 116 degrees. Ain't never been 116 degrees out here. We got 650 fires right now burning in California. 650 started by lightning strikes. Ain't never had no, I've been up here 35 years. I ain't never seen no lightning strikes the way they had them a couple of weeks ago. But because it was so hot and the weather's changing, you know, all these things are happening. And so people like Citigroup is putting up $250 billion against climate tech. And in the same way we talk about that, we're watching people get shot in the back. We're watching people get killed with feet on their necks and, you know, folks getting shot in the bed. All this stuff now with social media and the internet is reaching people who have a heart and who are not born of that, the mentality of some of their ancestors. So they've been successful. And so you got people like in Netflix, they're giving $125 million to black causes. You got Jeff Bezos' ex-wife, gave $100 million to HBCU. So there's a ton of that money out there like that, that even the government is trying to figure out how to keep people employed. So you have the PPP. I hope many of you took advantage of it. People say, I don't trust it. I'm going to have to pay it back, all that kind of stuff. That's not necessarily true. Because of our distrust of the government, most black people did not apply for PPP, you know. And guess what? The SBDC I just told you about was supposed to reach out to all of us and show many of us how to do it. I use my group to do just that for folks, because if you use that money the right way to keep people employed, even if they're not working, you still pay them because it's a grant. Because if you can show that you kept people employed, that loan becomes forgiven. That's why there are people who are getting $2 and $3 million worth of this money but they didn't have to pay any of it back because half the people that they were paying were still at home, but they were still on the rolls. So therefore, they were able to get that loan forgiven. And many of us didn't understand that, so we didn't apply for it, and therefore, we didn't do it. But those are the types of opportunities that are there. There's also, Lisa, I can't remember the acronym because I don't deal with it that much, but it's the emergency loan from the SBA. It's a 30-year note with 3.25% interest just to keep your business running. You can apply for that. Mm-hmm. I know it's very tough because many of us don't need more than 20 or 30,000, but can you imagine borrowing $100,000 for your business and not paying it back, and paying it back over 30 years with no prepayment penalty? That's what's out there. Mm-hmm. That's what's out there. And you can use the SBDC to, for somebody to tell you which way to go for that money. Another one is like, there are banks, and I've been telling Lisa, I was trying to buy a bank. I really want to run one. There's a black bank that was, first, I think, City First Bank in D.C. They merged with Broadway Bank in L.A. to form a different version of a black bank in California. We're now getting ready to work with them in a couple of weeks to certify them so they can do loans with an 80% guarantee to folks of color. So that's what we're working on as well.
Well, so, yeah, and I appreciate that. Some of the apps that are very usable to us, just to go back to Everett and Sanford as well, is Acorn, Robinhood, Stash. Who am I missing? Acorn, Robinhood, Stash. Those are ones that you can download those apps. They're really user-friendly. They'll walk you through how to use them. And some of them will even give you daily tips on which stocks are available. So always, you know, always utilize those. The Mint, it's not an app. Oh, well, yeah, it is an app, but it's called the Mint, and that helps you with budgeting. So there's a lot of things out there that we need to take advantage of so that we can have successful businesses. We get our money right, we have successful businesses, and then that's when the wealth comes. But, you know, so I wanted to make sure that we had this talk today so that everybody can hear and that we're sharing this information, and we're sharing it among ourselves, for ourselves, especially during these times. Because
Alicia, I'll tell you, you mentioned those three, and so I didn't really say much about that because that's more of personal money, but I'll let you know this. I am a user of all three of those particular apps that Lisa mentioned. There's also one called Webull, Lisa. There's a whole bunch of them. Those three are the ones you're going to see advertisements on. You're going to see them, but they're pretty established. Like what Everett was saying, when you look at Acorn, the reason why they use the word acorn, because acorns grow into mighty oaks, right? So they're saying that if you save subconsciously with Acorn. So they'll hook up your credit cards and your debit card. So whenever you go out to swipe it to buy gas, to buy food, to buy candy, whatever you do, they take and they do what they call a roundup method. So if you spend $1.50 buying some gum, they'll then round up the other 50 cents as savings. So they'll go into your, over time, they'll go up to $5. Well, they'll keep doing those roundups till they get to $5. And they go into your checking account and they pull that $5 and puts it into a savings for you. And what they do is they use, based on the questions they ask you, like the brother said, you know, if you're conservative, they'll put them in bonds mostly and large caps and stuff like that, dividend companies. If you're very aggressive, they'll put them into more like technology firms, small businesses, blah, blah, blah. And the Stash will do the same thing, but Stash will do it based on schedule. They'll say, you want $5 a week, take it out of your checking account and put it into stocks. They'll take the money out and then they'll invest it, not just in a conservative philosophy. They'll say, what do you want? Well, I say, I want $5 in Netflix. I want $5 in Wells Fargo. I want $5 in Nike or whatever. And it will go out and buy partial shares or slices of those stocks every week, every month, however you say it. And over time, you will develop money quicker than you will ever know. And the key, what he was saying, is try to find out which stocks. And what I would do, you guys, like you're having this pop-up right now, you call it. Well, we do these kind of Zoom calls every week with my kids, their cousins, and friends. And we discuss what strategy we're using. It's so funny. I was on a call last night, Lisa, in New York, right? Even from California, on the East Village radio show. And we were talking about the same topic. And I was telling them about NVIDIA. They got up in the morning and bought NVIDIA. By the afternoon, and this is just coincidence. Just coincidence, you guys. I don't know anything. I've been talking about this company, and Lisa can verify this, for about the last 4 or 5 months, because I know some, I just knew some behind the scenes type of things. This company has gone up from about $380 a share to about $525 today. If you want to look it up, always when we talk in symbols, ticker symbols, that was NVDA. So you can look that up and see what's going on. And you can say, wow, Sanford's right, right. So what I want to do is I'll take $50 a month and I'll buy it with Stash. And then every month, Stash will go and buy $50 worth. And over time, in 10 months, you'll have $500 worth, plus whatever it's appreciated. And so, and I just give you guys some examples, and Lisa's right. If you had $5,000 just 10, 15, maybe 10 years ago in Netflix, do you know how much you'd have today? Anybody want to take a wild guess? $5,000 just 11 years ago.
Come on, don't be scared, y'all. I didn't mute everybody.
Anybody want to take a wild guess? Take a wild guess. I'm on this phone way in California. Give me a wild guess.
Come on, Melanie. Give me
$1 million. I was going to say $1.2
million. Yeah.
That's very close. It'd be like $800,000,
$900,000. Wow.
11 years ago, $5,000. So where do you want to be 11 years from now? If you play with companies like NVIDIA, if you do companies like C Limited, which is SE is the ticker, those two companies. There's a company that's really, really, really new. It's called HHT is the ticker. And they're just a buck. I got them when it was 50 cents. But I'm going to tell you right now, it's a company that does online entertainment education. It shows you how to write scripts. It shows you how to prepare for going out for an interview or audition online. These are folks that are doing. See, those are the types of things when you have those Zoom calls by yourself with your friends, and always surround yourself with the kind of people who follow the kind of rules and have the kind of dreams that you have. Because, you know, I always tell people, don't ask folks for directions that ain't going where you're headed. And I told us the other day, you know, you'd be surprised when you surround yourself with. You hang out with four broke people, you'll soon become the fifth. So you have all these other, I got these little taglines I talk to my kids about. But, and they're right. They loved Marvel when we were coming up. So they bought Marvel. Marvel got bought by Disney. They love Pixar. Pixar's right here in Emeryville, right close to Oakland where we live. They love the movies, so they bought that. Using things that they like. Nothing about cash flow. They say, hey, man, they gotta be doing good. They make up, they're not having a good time. Let me own a part of that. And that's what they did. So that, from a standpoint of, and when you think of like your businesses, I'm telling you right now, that's what's going to happen as you guys get bigger. When you get bigger and you grow faster, you want to share your success. Think globally. Think the fact that there are going to be people who want to join with you, you know? And so you make wealth, did you become wealthy? This is my last guy. You know, you remember John Walton, Sam Walton? What store did he start, you know?
Oh, Walmart. The Walmart guy, yeah.
Walmart. He used to be a little funky little store, right? I go into a big box, but then he said, I want to in the Republican. He went and he had town meetings in the town. And all the people, because you know how folks are, they're going to back down. They bought stock in Walmart.
We're losing you, Sanford.
Can I jump in real quick, Lisa?
Yeah. I think we were losing Sanford for a minute. Yeah, jump in real quick, and then we're going to shut it down in about 2 minutes because I don't want to keep people too.
You there?
Yep.
So what happened really quickly? What happened, you guys, everybody in that town became a millionaire except for one guy. You know what that guy did? He needed a lawnmower. So he sold his shares and bought a lawnmower. And he was the only one that didn't make it in that town. And his family to this day have that lawnmower. And they keep it as a reminder of what a decision can do to folks. And all I'm saying to you guys is, continue to grow and think about your business, think about people, think about bringing people along, think about lifting as we climb, think about talking to each other about what we need to do. And definitely you can use me as a resource. Look at my website, has success stories on there, has things, always reach out with questions. And I have SBDC. If you wanna put in subject and put SBDC question, believe it or not, I have SBDC executives that go into my email because I have so many that questions. If they see SBDC, they will pull your email and they will answer it for me. So you guys have a personal consultant free of charge for a while and use it. Send some questions and see, no matter what state you're in, we'll find out who. Based on, and then whenever you send information, always send the state and zip code of where you're from. That way we can connect you, if need be, with the resources that are closest to you.
Okay. Thanks again, Sanford.
You're welcome.
I know, you know, it's a busy time for everything and everybody. Many blessings to you. I know you're out there with those fires. So just do your best. Stay healthy. Stay safe. And,
girl, the fires is even the least of it. Now we got the black plague out here with this crazy shit. And that's like 2.5 hours from my house. It's in South Tahoe. They got the first cases of the black plague. I'm like, yeah. Well, I'm looking for the frogs and, you know, looking for Jesus to come out, walk across the water, across the bay. I'm like, man, I'm keeping my eye out for a whole bunch of stuff.
All right. Well, we have another raffle. I will, and then I guess after we do the raffle, Big Brazos, Rachel, tell us a little bit about the raffle and who won that raffle.
Okay, we have our winner, which is Miss Ella Williams. Ella, if you would go ahead and email me send me your email. And we have Violet Whitaker, and I have her email. So we're good to go.
All right. So Ella, we wanna congratulate you. Are you still on?
Congratulations. Yes, I'm on.
Okay. Do you know what you won?
No. What did I win?
We wanna know.
Okay. Well, Big Brazos, tell them what they won. Tell them what they won.
Well, we have a sanitizer bundle. And that is from Aroma Stories. So that is one of our raffles. And that's for Miss Whitaker that asked?
And yes.
Miss Ella Williams.
The other lady too. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, Miss Ella Williams.
Most of us.
We have another one. We have the drawstring bag that is from Snapped, the official Snapped. So that's gonna be your raffle prize. And that's it for today, I believe.
Yeah. All right. I think those items are fitting for people.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
So Ella, any words of congratulations? Are you good? You glad?
Yeah, I'm happy. Yeah, thank you. It's a very interesting form. Very, very interesting.
Okay. Yes, lots of good information. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So again, I thank all the vendors that came out. Thank you for giving your gifts to everyone that came out. And we will be doing this again. We are going to try to do one at least once a month right now. So we plan to do one at the end of September. Of course, we're going to do one Halloween, around Halloween time. And then we're definitely going to jump into the holidays and Black Friday. So look for us again, and you're welcome. You're welcome to come back, present your items. You're welcome to come back, everybody who came back to visit us in the audience. We appreciate all the participants that came in the audience. So you just look for the upcoming emails that we'll send out for all products. Aroma Stories or Big Brazos, do you have anything that you want to say before we leave?
Thanks for coming. Yeah. I had a lot of fun. I know if I had fun, you guys did too. Thank you, DJ JMAZING. You kept it rolling. I was grooving. I appreciate that. Thank you, ladies. We're an awesome team. And I really appreciate you guys. And thank you to everyone for coming, because we need you here. And our businesses need you. Spread the word.
Yeah. That's great. Also, for tomorrow, everyone, spread the word. We have one more Pop-Up Shop show tomorrow. You can't forget that one. That is tomorrow, Pacific time, from 11 to 1. And then, of course, Eastern time, which is 2 to 4. So pass the word on to all your friends. And I think we're sending links for the, or you can go on our website to get the link, the live link.
Yeah. All the information will be in the links. We have a lot of information in the chat. I will ask one more time for all the vendors, put your information in the chat of how they can get in contact with you. Put your name, your header name, and how they can get in contact with you. So everybody else can look in there and see. We do have everybody listed, I believe, on the website and in Instagram. We have everybody listed as well. So, before I forget, any shipping that is done from any vendor that is here, any product returns or any of that is handled directly by the vendor, not by Pop-Up Shop. I did not get a chance to say that earlier, but I want to make sure that you know that if you purchase anything from here, it goes directly from the vendor to you. And then if you have anything you need to return or adjust or change, that goes directly back to the vendor and vice versa. If you need help locating the vendor, again, email us and we'll get you in touch with that vendor that presented their items on the show. But thanks again and have a good night, everybody. JMA.
Thank you.
Woohoo!
Clapper.
Take care.
Bye. Bye,
Sanford. Thank you.
All right,
everybody.
Good night.
Hi, Mom.
Hey,
baby.
Hey, Rachel.
Bye, Rachel. See everybody tomorrow. See everybody tomorrow.
See you tomorrow.
Oh, I don't know. Let's see. I'll unlock it. There you go. Try now. Try now, Aroma Stories.
Fun, guys. Yeah. Hit it.
DJ JMAZING.
Amazing.
Your name wrong. I see it's J-Mate.
It's okay. Honest mistake.
Yes. I got you though.
Okay, I think it's just us now. I think it's just us. So it's just the four of us. Ooh. All right. Can we breathe? Can we take a breather?
Yes. Woo! Yes.
We get through it.
Bravo, you like ladies.
Hands? Do you like J-Mazing's hands?
Yes.
Amazing. Very good.
I love Thank it.
You.
Like
I give you a nine. I would give you a 10, but I'm giving you a 9.
Okay. Room for improvement.
I give you
okay
a 10. I give you a 10. You did it.
I give you a 10.5 because I know it was a challenge, but I'm glad you worked through it with us. I'm glad we got some good music, good songs out there. So I appreciate it.
Not a problem. I do have one question. So, okay. So are we doing, is it 5 minutes or is it 10 minutes?
Well, we had to adjust some things because some of our vendors had to back out because they had to evacuate the fires. So gotcha. We had to make, that was a, as they say, they can't stop the show. So we had to make some adjustments. So we pivoted.
No problem. Because what I've been doing is when people go on, whatever, I just cut on the timer and then I just go with that. So I listen to, I have the timer going. Mm-hmm. And I'm starting the timer from when they introduce themselves. Yeah. But I could start the timer from when they start with their product and not their introduction and kind of keep an eye on it that way. And I can message you in the private chat because, I mean, I can do multiple things.
I think it's better to start not when they're doing their introduction. Start when they actually start showing product.
Okay, no problem. So then I can start when they start showing the product. I have a timer right next to me in my setup anyway, so I can go with that. And then the other thing is when you're transitioning, when you're so once the person is finishing and we're transitioning into the next person, do you not want me to have the music low and background-ish until you finish and then bring it up, or would you like me to keep it silent? Because that dead air sounds awkward.
I'm gonna say I know it's dead air, but that gives me the initiative to say, do you have any questions, or to add something if I know something, like when I gave a little testimony about Aroma Stories. So that gives me a little time to add. But after I'm quiet and I'm saying, then I'll cue you to say, we'll go, because sometimes I may not want to cue you, because if I'm looking at the time and the time is getting... We let the one person go a little longer and the time is getting a little more closer. Let me cue you to say, hey, we'll go to J-Mazing until that vendor's ready. Or I'll say, next up is, you know, Big Brazo's story. So if I just say next up is Big Brazo's, then we're going to go straight to Big Brazo. We're not going to do that. So that'll
okay. work. That. So you want to be able to control the flow of time. Okay,
yeah,
that makes sense.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, because once you go, then that takes the control away, and I'm like, ooh, you know, I have to break in and cut you off, and I don't want to do that either.
Okay. Also, the sound effects. Were you able to hear the sound effects?
I heard some of them.
Okay, so.
That sounds like somebody came to the bathroom.
It's supposed to be a hand clapping sound effect. I can find it.
Try it again. Let me hear.
When did you play it? What did you play it for? What was the sound effect?
When they won the raffle.
Oh.
I didn't hear it at all.
I didn't hear it at all either.
I would like to comment. I think as a DJ, you should always have your ear to us. like when one of us are trying to talk. I mean, like, you know when it's dead air.
Yeah.
So it's like, it's dead air. And then when you see us trying to talk, it's like, all right, bring it down. Just like on the shows that they do, you know, like on the late show, the music people are always there, but they know when the host is about to go. You know what yeah. I mean? It's like, I think it's a sensitive dance.
No, I get it. You want to set up non-verbal cues, which is kind of, that's kind of what I'm getting at, which is why, that's why I wanted to just kind of get clarification on it. I can be more towards that and just like let you do your thing, whatever, when you're transitioning, and instead of bringing it up. And then when I feel that you're winding down, then I can either bring it up slowly, but I just don't want to have a situation where you're winding down, I'm bringing it up slowly, and then something changes, and then I have to mute, because then it sounds
before
like...
Or you go back down, just like they do on the shows. Pardon me for eating you guys.
No, it's okay.
You know how they'll come in, and then the host got something to say. That's okay, just come back down.
Yeah.
Just come back down.
Yes, man, where is my banner? I didn't get my banner.
I didn't have it. That wasn't on my to-do list.
Okay.
Not to say it wasn't there. It wasn't on my mental...
Okay, no worries. Can I try to get it by tomorrow, maybe? Or we sure. Wait for the next one. Okay.
Okay. And I know we're
it's space, but anyway.
It was clean. It was clean.
It looks good. What's so we're here 11 o'clock tomorrow. So I will be
10:30.
Yeah, I was gonna say I was gonna be here like 10:30 or probably 10.
What did you think about Sanford and Everett?
I think Sanford was very informative. I think Everett, the guy who was talking about stocks, did not have enough insight to make it relevant,
or I think he needed more specifics
for people. Yeah.
Give us more tangible, like what is, like what are the stock price? Well, yeah, more yeah. tangible.
It's like
go on, amazing.
Oh, so I was just gonna. So the thing that I was gonna say is like what he was saying was great, and the information that he was giving was great, but when you start off your stuff with, hey, I'm not an expert and I only know about X amount in the information and stuff like that, but let me tell you what I know, then it has less weight to it than when Stanford starts off like, hey, I work in this is the space that I work in, let me tell you what I know. That's it just comes with more weight.
No, but that's the real. Stanford comes with more weight. Everett comes with less weight. And he just wanted to be blunt about that. Like, look, I'm just like y'all, but I'm not afraid to play the stock game. Pardon me, you guys. This is what I know. Let me just let y'all get comfortable and loose in this. Yeah, it's risky.
But I mean, I can understand that approach. It's like, hey, I'm just like you, and this is what I do. No, I can understand that approach.
And he was filling in. He was doing us a favor on top.
Right,
of that.
Right.
For sure.
So it showed. It just showed that he was filling in. But he was good. You know, he was good at, you know.
No, his information was relevant.
At least, yeah, I'm about to say, His info, I wasn't looking for a lot, but I was looking for accuracy. So you can give me one sentence, but if it's accurate, I'll take that over a whole bunch of flowery words that are just garbage. So yeah, I like the fact that what he said was relevant.
So I think what I see, which is really very, very important, the chat, and especially Diane has to have, she's with the jewelry. For her to really, like, she needs very specific, the numbers, the, what was it? The necklace and the earrings. That's where I was like, oh my gosh, okay. You know, I don't know if it's relative to put everything in there or do you just put numbers? So I don't know how people read it, but it was kind of interesting when we were doing that, me and Jess.
What do you mean? I don't understand what you're trying to say.
Well, basically,
we have to have numbers to our stuff, but go ahead.
So basically what I'm saying is that when we are doing the chat, whoever's doing the chat, of course, she had numbers to give to correlate with her products. But for the person that's doing the chat, you got to be... Ooh, boop, 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 boop. So I guess what I would say is that she may want to keep track of her own things so that I don't know. It basically
we did.
Saying
we did,
that
Rachel.
I felt the chat was real smooth because yeah, between the three of you getting the information out there.
Yeah.
But I feel like the chat was pretty smooth.
Okay.
I don't know if you guys, do you guys want to encourage other people to like chime in on the chat? Because like a lot of times near the end when it was like, hey, are there, is there any questions? I'm looking at the chat and I feel like people.
Nobody was chatting.
Yeah. So I don't know like if people felt intimidated about chatting or what's up.
You said that, like the chat is live. The chat is live.
The chat is live. I think more people should participate.
Yeah.
I can say we had consistent numbers. I thought that was great.
Yeah,
we
no,
didn't
it's,
a lot of, we didn't
it's,
have a lot of people jumping on and jumping off and jumping on and jumping off. We had consistent numbers. We have to continue to do what we do to increase our numbers. I think tomorrow we'll have a lot more. I think we'll have a lot more people, a lot more. You know, I think our vendors are ready to go now that they jumped in. So what did y'all think in regards? Okay, what did y'all think of the story guy?
With the comic book?
With the book.
His mic sounded incredibly better.
Right. That's what I was saying. Do you see the difference?
That was the first thing I noticed. I was like, oh my goodness, I'm so glad he got his mic fixed or whatever was the problem before, because I was preparing myself to be like, all right, here it comes. And his mic sounded so much better.
And I said, that's what comes with rehearsal.
Yeah.
That's an amazing story for a rehearsal. I was like, that's what comes with rehearsal, because
yeah, no, he was clear.